So good day po, we are the group 6 and we will be discussing about the instructional design. So we have here the backward design as a reference and it says here that the teaching method is misplaced. So teaching it is means to an end and having a clear goal help us educators to focus our planning and guide purposeful action toward the intended result. So next po. So here in backward design.
Meeting po.
So here po in backward design, first they will be identify their desired result and then determine acceptable evidence, then go as the planning, they plan the learning experience and instruction. So dito po, they are more focused on the outcome na agad, their desired result or the outcome. Then they followed on how they were going to teach these students. So more focus sila dun sa outcome and through that outcome, dun sila magbe-base ng kanilang teaching method kung paano nila tuturuan yung estudyante nila throughout the lesson. So agad-agad naka-base na sila sa result. Then the following event, dun na yung teaching method na gagawin nila, which is hindi siya exact. Wherein sa ginawa nating revise design, sige next po tayo. That's why we come up dito po sa revise design natin. Next po. So sa revise design natin is we are more focused on the instructional teaching. So first, we come up with the lesson. So dito sa lesson, dito nakapaloob, gagawa tayo ng lesson plan para magkaroon tayo ng guide to teach specific lesson sa mga student natin. Then followed the planning of the instructional teaching. Sa planning of instructional teaching naman, this is how we're going to teach the lesson to our students. Kung paano natin tuturo yung lesson natin na mas maiintindihan ng student natin yung lesson na ituturo natin. Then followed with the assessment and evaluation. So this assessment and evaluation, ito yung mga task and assessment and activities na ipapagawa natin sa mga estudyante natin. So the performance learning naman, ito yung mga group activity. So yung assessment and evaluation, it was individual. Dito sa performance learning, dito na nakapaloob yung mga group activities. We have sa atin, we have dance. Since nasa BPED tayo, we have also exercises and everything na magkaka-group. Other we have the other teaching, they have debate, 'di ba, yung mga grouping debate na ginagawa nila. So dito nakapaloob yun sa performance learning. So sa summary of result naman, ito na yung pagbibigay natin ng grade sa mga student natin based sa kanilang assessment and evaluation and then their performance learning. So bibigyan natin sila ng grade or yung score nila. So dito nakapaloob yun sa summary of result. Then followed by the outcome. Sa outcome, we have negative and positive outcome. So sa outcome, malalaman natin if the instructional teaching natin is nag-work o hindi. If the summary of result natin throughout sa ating mga student is higher than we expected, then the planning of our instructional teaching is approved, no? Kapag naman siya negative, so may mali sa instructional teaching natin. Then followed by the revise. Sa revise, it's either negative or positive. We have the revise. We will going to have a good decision. We will going to have revisions po, no? Para sa future teaching method na gagawin natin. Yeah. Po, next po.
So, unang-una is yung lesson. Identify the lesson you will be teaching on your students. Formulate a lesson plan for more understanding of a lesson. So, yun nga yung sinabi ni Vince kanina na kailangan gumawa muna tayo ng lesson plan para maging guide natin sa pagtuturo natin sa mga estudyante natin. So para mas madali yung pagtuturo natin at mas madali nilang maintindihan. Pangalawa is yung plan instructions and learning. In developing the revised backward design, it is a must to predetermine the course of action that provide direction throughout the lesson. So yun nga, yung pag nagre-revise tayo ng yun nga sa backward design. So kailangan ma-determine natin yung mga course and action na ano, magpo-provide sa atin ng direction yung sa buong lesson. So sa tulong nito, mas mapapadali yung pagtuturo natin. Kailangan maplano muna natin kung ano ba yung mga ituturo natin sa estudyante natin at kung ano ba yung kailangan nilang matutunan. So ito yung table 2, types of planning. On basis of focus tsaka on basis of time. So under ng on basis of focus is yung strategic planning, corporate planning, tsaka yung operational planning. Sa on basis of time naman is yung long range planning at short range planning.
Assessment and evaluation. Assessment is a feedback from the student to instructor about the student's learning. Evaluation uses methods and measures to judge student learning and understanding of the material for purpose of grading. Reporting both involves specifying criteria to observe the performance or outcome. Both requires the collection of data and other evidence by observing the performance or by looking at the outcome of the product.
Dito humingi tayo ng mga feedback sa student para malaman natin kung meron ba silang natutunan sa lesson at kung may na-share silang idea or natutunan about sa lesson, it means meron nga silang natutunan sa topic. Assessment and evaluation is important to improve student learning.
Performance learning. Measure of how well students are learning in terms of knowledge and skills development. Well-crafted performance assessment will help teacher gauge the levels of students' understanding, help the teacher to correct any student misunderstandings, and provide their knowledge and skills in learning environment that embrace their higher order thinking skill as well as relating into the real world situation.
Ako, example ko doon, reporting. Reporting, ganun, pag nag-report tayo, nag-share tayo or pinapaliwanag natin yung lesson, nagbibigay tayo ng ideas about sa lesson na tinuturo sa atin. Pangalawa is portfolio. Dito nilalagay yung mga document or activities na nagawa na natin.
Pwede rin dito yung sa performance. So, dahil nga BPED students tayo, halimbawa nga yung sa pagsasayaw. So, may measure din natin dito yung sa performance learning, yung pagde-demonstrate ng mga skills and ano. Halimbawa na lang yung sa folk dance. Sa una is tinuturo sa atin kung paano ito sayawin. So, pagdating ng dulo, so ipapaperform sa atin kung nasundan ba natin ito at ma-execute natin ng tama.
Summary of results. The results section is where report is defined or your study based upon the methodology or methodologies you applied to gather information. The results section should state the findings of the lesson arranged in a local sequence without bias to interpretation. Writing a summary of results does involve critiquing or analyzing the source, we should simply provide it to objective, accurate account of the most important information and ideas. The formulated set outcome for your students and teaching methods use. Ito naman sa summary of the course. Ito naman sa pag-sabi ko ng mga videos ng mga isang natin. Ito na, ano, ikita yung mga results. Paano kung gano ba kataas yung nakuha natin or bababa. Outcome, a final product of result. A result effect of an action. Conversion to knowledge. Describes a wider range of behavior knowledge. Knowledge and skill that makes up the bias. Up the bias. Basis of learning. Dito naman is yung ano. Yung outcome ng yung pagtuturo natin. If kung may natutunan ba yung students natin or wala.
So sa outcome din po is malalaman natin if yung the planning of instructional at ano po natin method of teaching is nag-work po, no? So sa summary of result, dito natin malalaman kung natuto ba yung mga estudyante natin o hindi. So magka ano sila? Tayo dito magkatabi lang sila lagi. Kapag yung summary of result is hindi na nag-work or mababa na yung mga scores or grades ng student natin, then meaning yung outcome natin is magiging negative. Then so kapag nag-negative yung outcome natin, yung planning of instructional teaching natin is hindi ganun ka-effective. So we do have the revision. Sige po, magbasa po ng revision po.
Revise. After all steps done, you will look over again to correct or improve, to make a new, amended, improve. To revise is to reconsider or change something. When you change your opinion on something, in this act, you'll be able to demonstrate an effective lessons and teaching methods by understanding the fact on how you formulate and discuss your lesson. You only have two results in here, wherein positive or negative results, which both a big impact in revising a instruction and teaching plan. So yung pagtapos nga ng lahat ng mga step by step na ginawa natin, so gagawin natin yung revision. So titignan natin kung tama o maganda ba yung outcome na nangyari. So kung hindi maganda yung outcome na nangyari, walang natutunan yung mga estudyante natin. So kailangan natin to i-revise na, kailangan natin palitan ng bago.
So yun lang naman po. So at ito yung nagawa nating instructional design. This is a revised backward design na ni-revise natin throughout the backward design, which is yung backward design po, no. Yung teaching method niya is misplaced. So meaning yung backward design na pinagkuha natin as a reference, naka-focus na agad siya sa result or sa outcome ng mangyayari. Bago pa yung isang teacher na magturo ng lesson. At yung ginawang nating revised backward design, we are more focused on the more focused tayo sa planning the instructional teaching, no, para makuha natin yung desired outcome natin at maituro natin ang mas maayos sa mga estudyante natin yung lesson. So yun lang po.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am, sir.
Thank you po.
Thank you po.
Thank you po.